The thin-skinned generals over at the Pentagon apparently don't like it when people say mean things about them on social media. So much so that their security details scour the internet looking for offensive messages after they retire. And thankfully, we know about this thanks to the reporting over at The Intercept. So first, let's give a little background. When generals enter into retirement, one of their perks is a personal security detail that's meant to protect them from threats. But apparently, they go way further than just identifying those threats. So let's jump into this reporting from The Intercept. The US Army Protective Services Battalion, the Pentagon's little known Secret Service equivalent, is tasked with safeguarding top military brass. The unit protects current as well as former high ranking military officers from assassination, kidnapping, injury, or embarrassment, according to Army records. Protective Services' mandate has expanded to include monitoring social media for direct, indirect, and veiled threats and identifying negative sentiment regarding its wards, according to an Army procurement document dated September 1st, 2022 and reviewed by The Intercept. Now, this document goes on to describe the software that they would use to acquire what they would consider a reliable social media threat mitigation service. The document says the PSIFO/PIB needs an open source web-based toolkit with advanced capabilities to collect publicly available information. The toolkit would provide the anonymity and security needed to conduct publicly accessible information research through misattribution by curating user agent strings and using various egress points globally to mask their identity. Now, keep in mind that's what's dubbed as publicly available information isn't only what's freely available online, it's also information that they commercially purchased, private information that was sold by surveillance firms and data brokers. It's not just the things you're putting out about yourself publicly online, it's medical records that are being sold by these data brokers. It's all sorts of invasions into your privacy. Now, according to The Intercept, the Army planned to use these tools not just to detect online threats, but also pinpoint their exact location by combining various surveillance techniques and data sources. This document cites access to Twitter's firehouse, which would grant the Army the ability to search public tweets and Twitter users without restrictions, as well as to do analysis of 4chan, Reddit, and YouTube. And they also want tools to disguise what they're doing. The contract says the Army would use misattribution, deceiving others about who is actually behind the keyboard. The document says the Army would accomplish this through falsifying web browser information and by relaying Army internet traffic through servers located in foreign cities, obscuring the stateside origin. I mean, Cenk, this is, of course, I should expect this type of egregious invasion into privacy from the United States government. But I mean, just reading it laid out like this is mortifying.
Yeah, I gotta be honest, I didn't expect it. This is totally over the top. So look, we report on their corruption all the time, in this case, the Pentagon. So for the rest of the mainstream media, that's verboten. If the Pentagon says something, it must be true. You put it as the headline, you don't even question it. And the generals are God's gift to humanity. And they talk about, they get this basically Secret Service equivalent as a perk. Here's another perk that they get. Giant contracts with military contractors, defense contractors, pay them off. Not all of them, but a lot of them. They get millions of dollars and they all know it. They all know that's what they're gonna get if they're good boys and girls when they're generals and stuff that Pentagon budget full of billions of dollars for those same contractors. So you know what? There, I just did a mean segment on you on YouTube, and here I'll spare you some of the trouble. We're in Los Angeles, so you don't have to go through all of that shenanigans to figure out where we are. So look, the only comfort I have, Ray, is that if they're looking at people who are saying mean things about retired generals, they're gonna go to Donald Trump way before they go to me, okay?
Right, and they don't need any research tools to find those comments. He's made them all over every right-wing news network he can possibly get on. And it shouldn't really be a surprise that the Pentagon was really reluctant to respond to any substantive questions about their social media monitoring. from The Intercept. Francis Sabold, a spokesperson for the Army Criminal Investigation Division, pointed The Intercept to a webpage about the office, which has been renamed the Executive Protection and Special Investigations Field Office. Now, Ilya Siatitsa, program director at Privacy International, had this to say to The Intercept: there may be legally valid reasons to intrude on someone's privacy by searching for, collecting, and analyzing publicly available information, particularly when it pertains to serious crimes and terrorist threats. However, expressing positive or negative sentiment towards a senior high-risk individual cannot be deemed sufficient grounds for government agencies to conduct surveillance operations, even going as far as pinpointing exact locations of individuals. And Cenk, if there's one thing I took away from law school, it was that that if the government says that what you're doing is a threat to national security or public safety, that they pretty much can invade your privacy how they see fit, and that judges will oftentimes rule with them. And I definitely left with a bad feeling about how America views privacy law.
Yeah, so look, we know that they were doing massive invasion of privacy and warrantless searches of all of us to begin with. But this is particularly nuts because look, if you find someone that says, hey, I'm gonna kill a former general, go get the sons of bitches, right? But if you're looking for information that's embarrassing or negative sentiments, are we using Secret Service like operation to protect their goddamn feelings? I don't care about their feelings. So this is absolutely outrageous. And exactly the kind of ridiculous crap that the Pentagon wastes our money on. So go suck on that while you're looking at mean tweets about ex-generals. I got a lot more where that came from. Most of them are crooks who love to take our money and give it to the guys who then pay them off later. So go research that.